In this video, I will show you a double tongue side graft useful for grafting stone fruit trees. I saw this graft performed last year in the southern part of California's Santa Clara Valley at the farm of Andy Mariani. Santa Clara Valley was once called the Valley of Heart's Delight and was famous for its delicious fruit. The valley's warm days and cool nights give it the ideal climate for growing stone fruit. Andy Mariani grew up in the Santa Clara Valley on his family's farm in Cupertino. Today, the Santa Clara Valley is known as Silicon Valley and is famous for technology. The current headquarters of Apple is close to what was once the Mariani farm. Apple is currently building a new campus in Cupertino to house more than 13,000 employees. Apple's plans include the planting of fruit trees in what was once an apricot orchard. In 1957, the Mariani family relocated its orchard from Cupertino to its current location in Morgan Hill. Andy's orchard grows hundreds of varieties of fruit, both heirloom and modern, focusing on varieties with the best flavor. After determining varieties that customers most prefer, more trees of those varieties are grafted. This type of graft is useful both when the diameter of the stock is small and also early in the season when the bark is not slipping and a bark graft is not possible. The first step is to cut off the tops of the branches to be grafted. The next step is to cut the bottom of the scion at an angle. The stock had an undesirable curve at the grafting point. Sawing it shorter revealed a straight part to better fit the scion. Next, a portion of the stock was cut off to match the exposed portion of the scion. Then the tongue in the scion was cut. A tongue was cut in the stock to match the tongue in the scion. Next, the scion was inserted into the stock. Then a second tongue was cut into the stock. The scion was pushed into the second tongue. Tapping pushed the scion in further to lock it in place and eliminate the need for a nail. Next, the graft was wrapped with vinyl grafting tape. Masking tape was then applied to prepare for the next step. The tape prevents the grafting seal from seeping in between the scion and the stock, which would reduce the chances of a successful graft. Here you see the healed graft almost a year later. The next summer, the tree will already be bearing fruit of the new variety. I highly recommend a summertime visit to Andy's Orchard for any fruit lover in Northern California. There are tasting events where a wide variety of fruits can be sampled and there are guided orchard tours. The remaining agricultural areas of the Santa Clara Valley are rapidly being paved over and covered with houses, so please do not miss this opportunity. If you happen to be a homeowner here, I strongly recommend that you plant an heirloom apricot tree to take advantage of the ideal climate. As with citrus, the source of budwood for grafting stone fruit trees is important. In California, all budwood for grafting citrus trees must come from a registered source. As of 2017, the situation with stone fruit budwood is different. The most serious diseases of stone fruit trees are not known to exist in California, but they are present in other states and other countries. Movement of stone fruit scions from certain areas can spread diseases that would be devastating to both farmers and also to hobbyists growing their own fruit trees. Sourcing stone fruit budwood locally helps to avoid the spread of disease. There are clubs in California that make locally sourced budwood of species that are not restricted available to hobbyists. Please see below for more information. Please help to save trees by understanding your local situation before grafting. You can also help by sharing this video, by giving it a thumbs up, and by subscribing to this YouTube channel. If you have an idea for a video that you would like me to make, please let me know in the comments below. Thank you.